What's up, everybody, and thank you for joining the channel. Enjoy the broadcast. I've been waiting to broadcast this next part, but I've been waiting for a couple of days till I could get off work and play it, and it's the Boston Tea Party, and I wanted to archive that because I love this mission. And I've been enjoying this game, the remaster anyways. It's okay. I mean, I got it with the season pass of, I bought the Spartan edition of the Assassin's Creed Odyssey, and it came with it, so I got it for free. Anyways, enjoy the broadcast. And feel free to hit that like and sub. And as always, game on.
Refuses to let them leave, wants us to take the tea, pay the duties, and say thank you kindly to the king.
The king can kindly kiss my arse.
You'd like that, wouldn't you?
You can kiss it as well.
Enough! What hope have we of resisting if we're arguing amongst ourselves?
If Adams keeps giving these speeches, he's apt to end up in stocks.
What happens now?
We wait for the signal.
What signal?
This meeting can do nothing further to save the country.
That one.
Evening, gentlemen. Shall we be off?
No.
What's the matter?
I have spent today drawn from one bit of madness to another with nothing to show for it. Before I go any further, I would like to know exactly what it is you intend.
Of course. First, we make our way to Nathaniel Bradley's house to fetch the rest of our little group. Then it's on to Griffin's Wharf, where we board the ships and dump the tea. Simple as that.
Simple seems a bit charitable.
Cheer up, Connor. For tonight, we are all victors. The Sons of Liberty get to send a message to England, and you rob William Johnson of his financing. Your village will be saved.
I've an idea. Why don't you lead the way? That should keep us out of any further trouble. Am I right?
Damn it, more guards.
We need to turn the crowd's anger to our advantage.
Say the word, Connor, and I will make it so. these bastards at bay while the tea's being dumped.
Let me help. I'm yours to command.
Gunner, we saved the last one for you. Thank you.
Best we get out of here, huh?
I was your snore era awe dinner of these sats dasser than on Jumunzage.
Kunakter Aguani did design of the Neganusesne. It is an actor yonder and no answer to the way and on done it on the Sakhdondi. Nuna oi in a skaho where the Dunhagaden. On the real dancer.
Radun hagedu, skanoruk stiguyan deres.
Sagada deriwasta ziata zaha yo snored de wageno. The wagemu in haraum ziwaga de westun haja.
Washe tari got dinahoda zezaks.
Zodio snored, I go deriandaratne, nectit kayana yeri waga tahidake.
On ayat the gayeri needs a dare on you.
Nectiat dangayeri gega.
Is a cock on Wadun does that the dirty what's a rug was, sir. Jogu de Gunga always negon or the Dunhagedu. I am what's your snorer down Dasanadara.
Yama. Alma. Yama. Yama.
Some folks were fixing to settle on a plot not far from here. Seems a big black bear with a taste for human blood settled there first. Bring the beast down and some good people would be grateful.
Thank you.
Yama. Yama.
Thank you. Oi! You, yes, you like to swing your mitts, eh? Down to the warehouse, the place men of your kind be meeting.
Yama. 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 Yama.
We'll be right back.
Find them. I will handle it.
Stop!
The trouble, Connor? Saw you tear past chasing a man.
He was trying to rob your home. It has been dealt with.
What? The women. Is everyone all right?
You should have been there.
What?
I told you to head back. Didn't I need you?
Since when is a skinny runt like you safe out in the bush alone?
If Diana's hurt, I swear you'll be the one paying.
Connor, Dad and Godfrey are fighting. You need to stop it.
I told you. I didn't need your help.
Oh, I didn't listen. None of this would have happened.
I'm fine. Leave it to me.
You need some sense knocked into you!
I may set you straight!
You need some sense knocked into you!
Luby!
You need some sense knocked into you!
I'm gonna smash you, you Luby! Oh,
You all right? There's no need for this.
Yeah. He's a blockhead.
He'll kill off in a spell. Just needs some time is all.
Are you not angry, Godfrey?
Me? Not at all. Terry's just got himself a temper, and I won't let him get away with it. It's really no trouble. He'll calm down. The runt couldn't do much damage anyway.
Does this happen often?
Ha! I was just telling Lance how I can set that calendar by these events. It's really not a worry, Connor. But I appreciate your concern.
You make a little more noise? Been fixing to trap a cougar I've seen prowling about. The beast has snapped two of my snares already. From what I've seen, its fur is white, mad as it sounds. Its hide would be worth a fortune to the right person.
I have never seen a cougar like that. I would like to help you.
I'll follow you then. Stay quiet. Trail yet.
size of those claw marks. Better shoot true. Fresh meat. Seen this before. Looks fresh. He's close. There he goes! We won't get another chance at this. Come on, Connor. We won't see him again after this. This is our only shot. Hurry up!
You must be here for my new friend. I was dumping a load and he went straight in. Lucky I wasn't in there.
Very. What are you thinking, Miriam?
Flush and fire. Norris can back off. One of us goes in there to draw him out, and the other waits out here to shoot.
I will go in.
Nice shot!
Thank you, Miriam.
Connor! Thank God you are here! Prudence is missing. She went out to gather some things this morning and never returned. I'm worried sick. What if she's hurt?
I will find her.
The dog might help track her down. He has a good nose. Come on, boy! She has been gathering the evening primrose almost every night. She is obsessed with the oil it yields. That is all going to stop now. I don't understand why she wants so damn much of the stuff. She picked some here. She can't be far. We should split up to cover more ground. Rudin!
much, Connor. Thank you. I don't want to think what might have happened if you had not arrived. I saw some primrose growing there, and the bear just came charging at me.
Why are you gathering primrose?
Well, Warren and I have been trying to conceive a child for a long time now. I read that evening primrose encourages fertility. I'm sorry, this is not a proper conversation given the circumstance.
I understand. Not another word on the matter.
Prudence! Are you all right, my love?
I'll be fine. Thanks to Connor.
Thank you, Connor. Once again. Hello, Connor.
Hello.
Is something the matter?
No, nothing that need worry you.
I would not pry, but please know that if there was anything I could do to help, I would.
It's all right. Connor already knows half of it. As you know, we've been trying to have a child, Connor, for a long time. Thus far, we have not been blessed even once. It takes its toll after a time.
You must not force such things. Nature will grant you with a young one when the time is right.
We hope you're right, Connor. At the very least, we are at peace here.
It is done.
Johnson is dead?
No. He retreated when we destroyed the team.
Only to hatch some new scheme, I'm sure. You should have killed him.
There was no need.
Time will tell if you speak the truth.
Ganondokong, why are you here? Has something happened?
William Johnson has returned with all the money required to buy our land. He meets with the elders as we speak. I have begged him to resist, but I fear he shall have his way unless you intervene.
How is this possible? We destroyed the tea.
The Templars are nothing if not resourceful. You should have heeded my warning.
Please, you have to stop him.
Of course. Can you tell me where they're meeting?
Yama.
Thank you.
izi na gan yadaradit ganusade ne Johnson si unja daro roxta. Guahi ganzi wat ne ganun haradun hagedum.
Ta guader harat guah kanto.
Thank you. plans might work.
What do you mean, might? We are all one. We should act this stuff.
How? By standing around those two, then we'll be one. The spirits will guide us as they always have. Did they not guide us here? Yes. That we might unmask the great. This is a mistake. We should sign.
Peace, peace. Have I not always been an advocate? Have I not always sought to protect you from harm?
If you wish to protect us, then give us arms, muskets and horses that we might defend ourselves.
War is not the answer.
We remember, Stanwix. We remember you moved the borders. Even today your men dig up the land, showing no regard for those who live upon it. Your words are honeyed, but false. We are not here to negotiate, nor to sell. We are here to tell you and yours to leave these lands.
So be it. I offered you an olive branch, and you knocked it from my hand. Perhaps you'll respond better to the sword.
Are you threatening us?
Yes.
Ensured an end to your schemes. You sought to claim these lands for the Templars.
Aye, that we might protect them. Do you think that good King George lies awake at night, hoping that no harm comes to his native subjects? Or that the people of the city care one whit about them? Oh, sure. The colonists are happy to trade when they need food or shelter, or a bit of extra padding for their armies. But when the walls of the city constrict, when there's crops that need soil, when there's no more enemy to fight, we'll see how kind the people are then.
The colonists have no quarrel with the Iroquois.
Not yet, but they will. 'Tis the way of the world. In time, they'll turn. I could have stopped it. I could have saved you all.
You speak of salvation, but you were killing them.
Aye, because they would not listen. And so, it seems, neither will you.
I was neyate hagum sere, am dahyayum neskanas is agum haja.
Thank you.
William Johnson is dead, and with him, the Templar plot to steal the land of my people. But in ending this threat, I have revealed another. On his body was a letter addressed to John Pitcairn containing orders to root out and destroy Patriot weapons and supply. Should he succeed in this, the colonists will be unable to maintain their resistance, and the Templars will surely take control. So long as Pitcairn lives, the danger remains. I need to find him. He needs to die. I thought it might bring clarity or instill a sense of accomplishment, but all I feel is regret.
Hold fast to that. Such sacrifices must never come lightly.
I had to do it. Not only for my people, but for all the others Johnson would have harmed.
It's a start. But to truly be free of Templar influence, all of them must be dealt with in turn. Even your father.
I know.
You speak the words, but do you believe them? Seems we've company.
What is it?
A request for aid from Paul Revere. Seems the Redcoats are up to something in Boston. Guess you made an impression on the Sons of Liberty.
They mistake me for one of their own. Please tell Mr. Revere he has my sympathies, but I cannot help at present.
You might wish to reconsider. John Pitcairn is mentioned by name.
Where am I to go?
Mr. Revere's house in Boston. If you'd like, I can...
Afternoon!
Hello, sir. Would you like a draught of ale or some bread and cheese?
Connor! This here is Oliver, and that is Corrine. great people. Ollie, this is Connor, the man I was talking about. The Lord of the Manor.
We were passing through, is all, and met some of your townsfolk. They were thirsty, and we had some barrels in the back. And
I am no lord, and these are my friends, not my townsfolk. What brings you to the road with a cart full of spirits for sale?
We were innkeepers until the king took our inn for some military such and such, left us out on our round bar.
Hey, you should settle here. We could use an inn.
Good idea.
We would, but without the inn itself, we don't have much choice, and building one isn't cheap.
We certainly have a need for something of the sort. I will speak with my friends at the mill and see what we can do about building ourselves one. If it can be arranged, would you consider ending your search here?
Of course, Ollie. We'll have an inn again.
This should suffice.
Thank you. You won't regret this, Connor. We promise. Delicious, love. Connor, what brings you?
I was passing by, and I thought I would stop in and see how you were faring.
Well, that's nice of you. Well, my boy, we are faring very well.
Between those who live here, the sailors coming and going from the pier, not to mention the travelers, our beds are always full and our taps are always flowing.
I am pleased things have worked out for you here.
As are we, Connor. I'd be lying if I told you we weren't worried when we were ousted from our old place. But the Lord works in mysterious ways.
Connor!
Gentlemen, you seem to be getting along.
Oh, aye. We're just on our way to have an ale. You might have noticed, I've got a bit of a temper problem. Oh, Diana's fine, Spuds are fine. We've got a good thing going on here. I'm just happy I didn't hurt old Godfrey. Wouldn't I have been able to forgive myself?
So am I, Terry. So grateful you didn't poke me with your tiny fists.
Do nae rile me up.
All right, take it easy.
I am happy things are well again.
Connor, come with me downstairs.
Should I search for something to fill that space?
No rush. Eventually, the right piece will present itself.
As you wish.
There's a chest in a cave on the edge of the property. Could you retrieve it for me? I would go myself, but these old bones prevent me from getting to it. Take Norris with you. The cave entrance is blocked with heavy stone and will need to be cleared one way or another.
Yama.
Norris, I'm going to fetch something for the old man, and he told me there might be some stone that requires clearing.
Yeah? I will bring my explosive. Is interesting.
Certainly not your typical colonial woman. A deadly shot.
She brought down that cougar. She is strong, capable. She has no husband?
Not that I'm aware of.
I never met a woman like her before. I would like to know her better.
You should speak to her then.
I might try. Hey, don't splash. Don't want to get the powder wet. Do you think she likes Frenchmen?
I see why he encouraged me to enlist your services.
Pas de problème. We blew it up. Be my guest. Duck and cover! That's a nice one!
Thank you.
Bienvenue. Doesn't look safe in there. Be careful. I'll be at the mine. What you said about Miriam is interesting.
close.
Yama.
I have what you asked for. I must know who put it there and for what purpose.
I did. I put it somewhere I knew only I could reach. But that was a long time ago.
Who does that belong to?
These were the robes of the first assassin to come to the colonies.